Hello and welcome back to Proactive. We are live at Resourcing Tomorrow and I'm joined by Tim Dobson, who is the CEO of Magnetite Mines. Tim, fantastic to have you up here.
Thank you very much. Pleasure to be here.
Yeah, welcome. Now, give us the Magnetite Mines story before we go any further.
Sure. Magnetite Mines is a company that is singly focused on developing the Razorback iron ore project in South Australia. It's a massive project with 6 billion tonnes of resources in the ground, and only recently the economic conditions to make it viable have emerged thanks to the decarbonisation agenda across the iron and steelmaking industry that has made this project now ready for development. So the company has transformed from developing as a junior explorer-focused company to a serious development company. And that has meant a transformation of our board of directors in the last year, going from a board of 3 to 6, bringing in 3 highly credentialed new board members that are necessary to take on a development such as this. Finding a new CEO such as myself, I joined the company only 3 months ago, on August the 23rd. We have a new CFO that started only 2 months before me, and we have some other senior staff that have been brought in the last 12 months. We've established a corporate head office in the central finance district of Sydney, Australia now, where we're now starting to negotiate our financing and our balance sheet and our registry restructuring. And the other key piece of information, I guess, that's important is the demand for the product that this project will deliver has become large and urgent because of this decarbonisation agenda. And what the company found after COP26 in Scotland last year was a rapid ramp up in that interest. So I've been presenting to a range of downstream large industry players in the Asia and subcontinent regions, both steelmakers, trading companies, and some other players who are now looking to secure this product for the future. So it's really a transformation story. It's happened fast. So a junior company with a 3-man board now is a large company in the CBD of Sydney, setting up what will be an extremely large project.
Understood. So it's transforming, but what do you think it's going to be transforming into in the end?
What we're going to see with this project is not simply just a standalone mine. Our project is in a completely undeveloped iron province in South Australia. It's a very low socioeconomic region of the country. And if we get this right, we'll be, I guess, the first mover to open up what could be a century of production out of this iron ore belt, with even the potential for South Australia to restart a steel industry with the green steel credentials, because the state has everything that's required for that to happen, including lots of magnetite ore. And as you said, we've got 6 billion tonnes already in the resource state. They're putting in hydrogen production as we speak. There's natural gas in the state, which is needed for the modern style of steelmaking using direct reduction. And they have a renewable energy grid, so we can tap into energy from the sun and wind directly off the power lines. We don't have to put in our own solar or wind farms. They're coming off the grid. So this could be transformational for the particular region of the state and an Australian significant project for the future.
So it's a big project. It's a potentially very beneficial project. And they've brought in a very experienced guy to run it. I feel like I'm clutching at straws trying to think what really could go horribly wrong with it. What is it that you're concerned about in terms of challenges?
So magnetite mines compared to, say, hematite mines, which are the traditional, what we call direct shipping ores for iron ore, where it's about 1.5 billion tonnes a year get dug out of the ground, put onto ships and sent to places like China. For steelmaking. Magnetite mines require processing at the site, and that's why this project is actually still in the ground. Its economic conditions haven't been viable until now. But once we process it on site, we produce a very high grade of iron ore. So when you think about that, we've got all of the complexity of moving large volumes of high grade iron ore, just like a direct shipping ore company does, rail, port, large ships. We've also got the complexity of a very large processing plant and tailings dam on the site. And we've got the complexity of scale itself. Everything is large and we need a large workforce. So these are the things, I look at everything through a risk lens. And so have we got enough, can we get enough people in to run? Australia's extremely tight on labour, for example, at the moment. Can we build such a big project on time and budget given the inflationary cycle? Can we get access from all the landowners that we need to cross over, bringing in our power and our water and our trains, for example? These are the risks that keep me awake and will be the hurdle race that needs to be run through to get to the finish line and bring this into production.
Mm-hmm. Well, it sounds like you're fairly confident regardless.
I haven't got an iron ore background, but this project was very compelling to me. And when I was asked to consider the role of CEO, I looked at it very carefully and I'm extremely excited. It's such a big project. I'm probably in the last 10 years of my executive career. It's good to be back in Australia. I've worked overseas a lot, and to be able to hopefully preside over a project that is it's going to have such a big socio-economic impact, it would be extremely satisfying.
Fantastic. Well, fortune favours the brave, and let us wish you the very best of luck, Tim.
Thank you very much. Hopefully I don't lead it.